Today I will go into the details of the probability distributions we use all the time in the Monolix algorithms. In our more technical videos or on the online documentation, we have talked about probability of y, the probability of y given psi, the probability of psi, or the probability of psi given y. So let's see what they mean, if they have a closed form solution, and how to write it. To make it more concrete, I will consider a simple example with a model with one compartment, a linear elimination, and a bolus administration. The model predicted concentration can be written like this, with a decreasing exponential over time. It depends on the dose D, on the volume Vi, and the elimination rate Ki. The I index stands for the individuals. Each individual has its own Vi Ki values, leading to a different prediction. When I know Vi and Ki, I can calculate the predicted concentration at any time t. Times at which it is important to have a prediction are the times of observations of the dataset. They are indicated with an index j. Here I even write I and j because observation times can be different for each individual. I call psi I the individual parameters of individual I, so in this example Vi and Ka together as a vector. This is only the structural part of the model. For the statistical part, I need to define the distribution of the individual parameters within the population. I can, for instance, assume that Vi and Ki follow a log-normal distribution that I can write like this, with eta, the random effects that follow a normal distribution with mean 0 and standard deviation omega k. Vpop, kpop, omega v and omega k represent the population parameters that characterize the population to which the individuals of the dataset belong. Altogether, I will call them theta. As part of the statistical model, we also need to define how the observations from the dataset are related to the model predictions. This is done via the residual error model, and I will here use a constant error model. I can thus write that the observations from the dataset yij are equal to the model prediction plus an error term. Epsilon represents a standard normal random variable, and a is the magnitude of the error. This equation means that the observations are random variables that follow a normal distribution centered around the model prediction and with standard deviation a. Now that we have all this in mind, let's put it in a corner and move on to the probability distributions. The distribution that we use all the time in the Monolix task is the conditional distribution. It is a probability distribution of the individual parameters for each individual given the observed data for this individual. Actually, this distribution also depends on the estimated population parameters theta. During the estimation of the population parameters, we would write it with a superscript k to indicate that we are working with the current population parameters at the iteration k of the SAM algorithm. Once the population parameter task is finished, the population parameters theta are known, and we tend to omit it to have a simpler syntax. But it's always there. As a reminder, this conditional distribution is defined for each individual I, and it represents the uncertainty of the individual parameters. The individual parameters are vector, here Vi and Ki, so it is a multivariate distribution. This probability distribution has no closed form solution. The only way we can approach it is to sample from it using a Markov chain Monte Carlo procedure. This is what we do in the task conditional distribution, and it has been explained in the feature of the week number 86. We also sample from it using the same procedure during the SAM algorithm, this time with the current population parameter estimate theta k. See video 45 for this. For some of the tasks, such as the EBEs, we will explain in the next video, it is convenient to use the Bayes law to write this conditional distribution as a product of several terms. So let's check these terms one by one. The first term is the probability of observing the data of individual I given its individual parameters Psi. We usually have more than one observation per individual, so we can write that it is a product of the probability distribution for each observation at time tj for individual I. For a given individual with known individual parameters Psi I, it tells me if measuring, for instance, a value of 10 mg per ml at times 3 hours is likely or not. We have seen that the observations follow a normal distribution centered around the model prediction. So we can use the typical formula of the probability density function of a normal variable to write the distribution. In this formula, everything is known. A is a population parameter. This is the model prediction I can calculate if I know the individual parameters. And this is the data. So if I give you the individual parameters Vi and Ki for one individual, for any observed data point of this individual, you can calculate the probability to observe this value with this formula. But you need to know the individual parameters, and this is why here it is given Psi I. Now let's check the second term. P of Psi I represents the probability of the individual parameters. So the probability distribution of the individual parameters within the population. We have assumed that we have a log normal distribution for B, so we can simply write the probability density function of a log normal distribution. It tells me what is the probability that an individual from the population has a value of, for instance, Vi equals 50 liters. This distribution tells me about the entire population, not about a specific individual of the dataset. As Psi is a vector of parameters, I need to multiply the probability of each parameter. In case of a diagonal omega matrix without correlation terms, I can just write it like this. In case of correlations, the formula is a bit more complex. And finally, the last term is the probability to observe the data at hand. Remember that this is given the population parameters theta, and this is actually the definition of the likelihood. When I'm optimizing the population parameters theta, I'm looking for the theta value that gives the highest probability to observe the data I have in my dataset. The likelihood has no closed form solution. In Monolix, we have two different ways to calculate it, either via linearization or via important sampling. This will be the topic of a future video. Now you know all about the probability distribution we work with in Monolix. Have a nice week!